Hi, I'm Joshua Farnsworth, and welcome to my traditional woodworking school. In this video, my friend Bill Anderson will be sharing a tutorial on how to make a curved mortise and tenon joint. And this comes from a really historical Howarth bow saw that you can see above my head up there. So I really hope you enjoy this video and hope you learn a lot. Thanks for watching.
We're going to lay out the mortise here, and this mortise off of my template here is 5/16 of an inch wide, so I'm using a 5/16 inch mortising chisel, and I've got a mortise gauge where the pins have been set to match the width of this chisel. And again, referencing off the reference face, I'm going to scribe the two shoulders, the two cheeks of the mortise. And there I've done that. I'll just pencil these in so you can see them a little bit easier. Now, since I always use the reference face for the marking gauge, when I do the other side, this other piece, I'll use the same reference face. And that way my mortise will be in the same plane throughout the whole tool. And that's important, because you may not have this perfectly centered, but if it's the same offset on both pieces, then it's good. So we've got the mortise laid out. I'm clamping this work down so that my work is right over the bench rather than over the hole in the spacing device. So as we chop through here, we're just going to do like any old mortise and work this back way back and forth, follow the bevel as I work across, and we're going down about 3/4 inch, and I've set a little combination square to 3/4 inch so that we can. The thing about this mortise here, all the mortises in this project, is that it doesn't have to be a tight mortise. These are not the type of mortises that your mama taught you to make. These are the type of mortises that are just to hold this thing together. They can be loose and it'll be just fine, because all the structural integrity of what's going on here is through the tool itself. It's not due to the strength of the mortise joint there. So I'm just sort of breaking up the chips there, and we'll continue doing this. Until I got these chips out, I've set my combination gauge to 3/4 inch. So I'll continue going back and forth until this gauge will bottom out to 3/4 inch depth. And that'll be the final depth of the mortise. Now remember, the mortise is going to have a curved shoulder. We're not taking that into account right now. We're just making the rough shape of the mortise 3/4 inch. And then later on, we'll shape the curved part. So I'm going to go back and forth, finish out this mortise here, and clean it up to the final depth. And then we'll do that on the other arm as well. And we'll have completed the joinery for the arms, and we can turn our attention to shaping and so on and so forth. So we've laid out all the important shoulders of this stretcher. And now we're going to cut the tenons on both ends. The tenons are going to have the same mortise gauge setting that we used for the mortises right here. In other words, they're images. And again, we're going to obey the face side rule so that our tenons will be flush with this surface over here. So let me just go ahead and do that. Let me just go ahead and scribe in my So I'll just work my way around here, face side rule. And then the mortise is laid out between these two shoulders here. Same rule, face side rule right here. So we'll just go ahead and lay this out. Now I don't worry about having my marks go past the layout lines because that's information that's good to have encoded into your stick so that you can see where the actual dimensions are supposed to be once you've sawn things out. So that's a useful thing to do. So we've laid out the mortise, the two tenons. We'll go ahead and saw these tenons out. And these tenons are just like any tenon you ever have ever sawn, in that you need to knock out the expose the shoulder there on each side. And using that as a starting point for a nice rip cut. Get a little better angle on that. And I'll do this side as well. You want to saw up to the line, but not over it. We'll reverse this. Same thing over here. I like to knock out these things here, make a little V cut. It really helps me to have a good start with my tenon. Oops. Now, you remember that here's the final end point of the shoulder. The shoulder is going to be curved. So you can run this saw cut down to here, but at a shallow angle. Let me just go ahead and do that. I don't want to cut very deep here, but taking that right down to that point there. Will help in this next step. So I've cut the shoulder all the way around. And now I'm going to, cut the cheeks all the way around. And now I'm going to cut the shoulder off. And the shoulder is going to be cut off at this point right here. And then I'm going to pare that out to follow this curve. So let me go and do that. I'll use a bench hook for that purpose. And we'll use a little crosscut saw. It's important not to saw down into your tenon. It You can knock that off like so. And then we'll do that on the other side and these two ends here. But let me just go ahead and chop out this shoulder. Now, in the original saw, you could see the beveled cuts that the maker had done to get this curve here. It actually did just 5 chops with a chisel to make this curve. And they did not shape it to an even arc or anything like that. So I want to make that first cut so it's right to the shoulder there. Then basically you're looking for tangents to the curve all the way around. Last one right there. And we can clean this up just a little bit. So that pretty much gets a curved shoulder. Here's the actual, remember I said this is the actual shoulder to shoulder distance right there, but this is the part that goes into the mortise in the arms right there. So we've got that, and so we'll continue on to do that on these other arms here. What will be important is the height of this shoulder here should match the height of the shoulder over here. As we look down the two shoulders and look on both sides at the same time, we should see that we have the same height across the full arc of the curve of the shoulder on both sides of the cheeks of the tenon. And that way we know that when this tenon seats in its mortise, it's going to seat top and bottom equally, so that the strength of the joint will be straight through the arm, straight through the stretcher, straight out this way. Nothing tilted or off kilter or anything like that. So we will spend some time making sure that these shoulders match up on both sides. I finished cutting the shoulders to each of the tenons here, all the way around. Curve them with several cuts of the chisel. And then the only other thing to do is to cut the length of the tenon to match the depth of the mortise that it's going to go in. Remember that mortise was 3/4 inch. So the distance from here to there, I want to be less than 3/4. I made it 5/8. It doesn't have to bottom out. It's not getting its strength from being tight in there. We just want there to be room for this stretcher to rotate through the mortise right there. And for that reason also, I've laid out some bevels right here to make this stretcher more of a rounded shape. The original one just had 2 bevels on here, and that was enough to make this tenon functional in the mortise in the arms. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that real quick. Put this in here so you can see that. And the first bevel is going to be coming right here from the beginning of the and then the second bevel. And then I'll do the same thing on the other side. So I'm starting right at the base of the tenon. You can see that right there. And then So I wind up with a curved tenon as well. So let me go ahead and do that on this part right here real quick. First, we need to saw this off, and I've already marked it for 5/8 of an inch. So we'll go ahead and saw that off here. And then I'll lay out these bevels. You know, this is really just by eye. First long bevel, second bevel right there, just to get it into a curve. And then we'll be able to assemble this saw. The bottom line is, once we get to this point right here, we really have a saw. We'll be able to practically assemble it, except for one minor detail. But for all practical purposes, we will have this thing organized. After this, all over but the shouting. So here's our two arms. I won't put the blade in, but I will orient everything in the manner in which it's eventually going to be. These tenons will go in there like so. Of course, the blade will be down here, so we really have a saw. Put some string on here, we're ready to go. Be a little bit hard to use this saw. It'll feel a little angular in the hands. The only detail that we're going to leave out for this very moment, and we're going to save it till the very end, is cutting this curved shoulder right here to match this curved shoulder of the tenon. That's going to be the very last thing we do after everything else is done. We'll do that with a rasp, and we'll just fine-tune that until the shoulders are mate perfectly. And remember, the other thing that we need to look at is, are these two shoulders the same height? So we want to spend some time tweaking these two shoulders so that they're the same height along the full curve. So I actually hold this up to my eye and look at each part of the curve as I'm going along to see if one shoulder is higher than the other. And once I've determined that, I will come back and pare that down with a chisel until they're both the same height. Now, it doesn't matter that these shoulders have the same curve as the other end. They'll have the same curve on both sides here, but it could be different than this end. We're going to fit that to the arm later on by trial and error. But the shoulder heights have to be the same. Otherwise, the arm will fit in here cockeyed, and the stress through the saw will be, there'll be an angle there, a cockeyedness. So that's important to spend some time looking at these shoulders and seeing that they're fine. Over here, one of these shoulders is high. This one right here is high relative to that one. I can see that all the way through here. So I know I've made this arc a little bit too far up, and I need to bring it down to match this one here. So we'll do that in the course of this project as we go along. We're down to the last shaping step here, and that's to shape this mortise shoulder here to match the tenon shoulder here. And I wouldn't say this is a particularly critical joint here, but it looks visually, it's important. So we're going to take some time with that. When we get ready to lay out these shoulders here, you can see that on this particular arm, I've laid out the end walls of the mortise with pencil here, and I've carried it across to each of the faces here so I can see how far that arc is going to span right here. And then I laid that arc out with my template here, and I've brought that template up so these two lines right here match, lay right on those lines there, and bring them up until they all intersect, allow for the width of the pencil, and then draw in that arc. So let's go ahead and do that on the other arm right here, right now. So I've laid out the end walls, ready to make the mark. So I'll bring this up right, pull it back just a wee bit to allow for the width of my pencil mark, and draw that in. Now we're going to be shaping both these shoulders at the same time, rasping straight across. So we want to try and mark these as carefully so that they're the same mark. We're actually going to do the actual fitting using the tenon that goes to the correct, and you can see here's a reference mark here, reference mark there, reference mark here. So I know that this arm goes on that tenon, and that tenon, this stretcher is arranged in this way like that. So let's go ahead and put this in the vise and rasp this curve out a little bit with a coarse rasp here and see how close they are. I'm going to use a couple different rasps here. This larger rasp, which is practically matches almost the curve of this shoulder here, and a finer rasp to sort of work the So I'm just going to go right down the middle first and get close to depth, focusing on holding the rasp horizontal to the work. Until I get close to depth, and I'm going to start looking at these lines. I don't want to rasp past these two shoulders here, so I want to be careful when I creep up. Now, if you make the if you make an error in the curve of the shoulders, you have the option of working this down a little bit further or changing the curve of the mating tenon here as well. So you will wind up going back and forth to tweak those. We're pretty close to the line. I'm closer on this side than I am on that side, so I probably need to raise my handle up just a little bit here. Let's take a look and see how this is going to match. Here's my reference face here. Here's my reference face there, so I can put these together and see how much they match. So I can see I've got a little bit of gap here and a little bit of gap here. So that tells me that this curve is not quite deep enough in the middle to mesh well there. If I look on this side, it looks like the curve is plenty deep right here, but not quite so deep there and over there. So I'll need to try and focus. I'll go ahead and mark these so I know where I'm going to do my rasping. So the areas I'm going to focus on. And we'll try and do this individually without working on this, without working on that. We could use gouges here as well. So I'm just going to deepen this here just a little bit. And then we'll turn this around and work on those two shoulders right there just a little bit. And this process is trial and error. I'm just going to have to do this bit by bit. keep doing that until we get a good fit. So that's starting to look pretty good right there. And, you know, it looks pretty decent right there also. We could tweak that a little bit more. Eventually, you can see that this surface here is a little bit higher than that surface right there. There's a slight discontinuity. So eventually, I may rasp down this surface here to match these two so that they are flush. This stock here was just a tad wider than that stock there. So that's a good thing to do, is make those fit there. But that works pretty good, and you can see that the stretcher can rotate a little bit on this axis here, and that rotation allows this to open up or close to account for variations in the length of the blade and whatnot. So we'll go ahead and work on this and tweak that just a tad more maybe. Do the same thing on this side, and then we'll string our saw together and look at the overall result.
If you're interested in learning traditional woodworking, come take a class at our school in Earliesville, Virginia. You can also visit our website at woodandshop.com, where you'll find a bunch of free woodworking lessons, workshop tours, and our very popular tool buying guides. And make sure you subscribe to our free newsletter to get our latest articles and videos. Enjoy!